Greetings, mathophiles, and welcome to a very short video on how to use a dedicated calculator program on the TI-84 to evaluate Riemann sums. You may know that there is a built-in finit command that will give good approximations to definite integrals on the calculator, and I'll put a link in the description to a video on how that works. But you may be from time to time asked to make a specific Riemann estimate using left endpoints and 20 subintervals, or right endpoints and 10 subintervals, or something like that. And for that purpose, your calculator doesn't have a built-in way of approaching it. You can do a bunch of wrangling in the list editor, but your life will be much, much easier if you have a dedicated calculator program. We're going to look in this video at one that I give my students called LRM, but there are plenty of things out there, and they would all end up working in essentially the same way. You have to tell the program what function, what integrand you're integrating. You have to tell what the limits of integration are. You have to give the number of subintervals, and then the calculator, most programs will spit out a left, right, and midpoint Riemann sum, and some will also spit out a trapezoid or a Simpson's rule estimate if you're familiar with what those are. So, real quick example, we want to evaluate the integral from 1 to 4 of the natural log of x dx. If you are a calculus AB student, as are my students, you're not going to know how to anti-differentiate that. It requires a technique called integration by parts. But it may be the case that you even know how to make the antiderivative and use the fundamental theorem to evaluate the integral, but you may have been asked to find a specific Riemann sum estimate. So here's how these things tend to work. You need to enter the function, the integrand. And so our function is the natural log of x. And then you need to run whatever program you're given. So I'm going to hit the program button. And the one I'll be using is called LRM for left, right, middle. I suppose we call it LMR if we wanted to take things in order from left to right. So I'll run that. And any program that you would use for this purpose would basically ask you for the same information in roughly the same way. So my left or lower limit of integration is 1. My right or upper limit of integration is 4. And let's suppose that we're asked to do 20 midpoints, okay? So I will enter 20 for the number of subintervals or parts, because it takes up less space on the screen, and out they come. A left endpoint Riemann sum, a midpoint Riemann sum, and a right endpoint Riemann sum. We were imagining that we had been asked for the midpoint sum, so we would say 2.546. It's worth noting that these do increase from the left to the midpoint to the right, and that should be unsurprising given that our integrand is an increasing function. So if you take the leftmost value on a subinterval, you're going to get the least possible value for each subinterval, and the rightmost, you're going to get the greatest, and anything in between, you're going to get something in between. You can pretty easily, with the information that's here, get a trapezoid estimate. That's just the mean of the left and right midpoint estimates. And if you know anything about Simpson's rule, you know that that is a weighted average of these three Riemann sums, where the midpoint is worth 2/3 and the left and right endpoints are worth 1/6 each. So in an emergency, you could make those estimates. You could also very easily modify any program that you were given, or it may have come to you this way, such that it would spit out also the trapezoid and Simpson estimates. That's all I've got. This was quick and dirty. Hope you find it useful. Happy mathing.